President of France.
Well,
bonjour, Sharon. Good to see you, and I have to see you here.
Come in.
This is all official.
We saw how well you looked when you spoke before the General Assembly 3 days ago. You looked very fit in full form on that occasion. I see that they are still under the same iron hand, Mary Mascherini ruling them with an iron hand. That's Mary Mascherini, the office of Fogel. She's the general of the press. I read your statement very carefully.
We might learn something from the French because they've been able to get their hostages back from Iran. Might you be discussing with the president how they succeeded?
Well, I don't know whether we'll have time in our meetings with all the things we're going to talk about, but yes, I'd be interested in that.
Mr. President, what kind of message do you hope to convey to the ethnic leaders you're going to meet with in Chicago tomorrow? What's the message you're going to take there?
Well, it's going to be a message about the part they play in America, how we're probably the most unique country in the world in that regard, that we are all of us. It came from someplace else.
Mr. President, do you have any understanding of what is happening in the Soviet Union with the Politburo meeting and Mr. Shevardnadze's abrupt departure?
I would be hazarding a guess, but it seems to me that there is some controversy there among the government figures and about proposals that the General Secretary has made, and I imagine that's what they're going to talk about.
Are you hoping that the General Secretary is successful in quieting the controversy?
Yes, because I think most of the things he's suggested are very good and very progressive.
Monsieur le Président, est-ce que vous avez vraiment un espoir d'arriver le problème des armes chimiques? Et pourquoi est-ce que vous avez fait changer de position dans la France sur la destruction des stocks de sécurité?
J'ai voulu contribuer à un accord général sur la véritable
cessation de l'emploi chimique. Vous savez qu'il y a déjà des conventions à ce sujet, mais bon, elles n'ont pas été respectées. Une conférence est donc nécessaire pour en finir avec cela. Et d'autre part, j'ai bien dit qu'il s'agissait pour la France de s'en tenir à la position que j'ai indiquée lors de l'entrée en vigueur de la future convention. Cette précision n'est pas inutile dans ma réponse. C'est remarquable grâce à l'action des Nations Unies. Et puisque les membres du jury du prix Nobel avaient décidé de porter leur choix sur les Nations Unies, la spécification pour s'agissait des forces de paix et de l'intelligence.
Vous pouvez répéter ?
Je ne suis pas un membre du jury.
Je
ne sais pas ce qui se
dit. Privé
de ce jury.
What they are saying privately.
Thank you.
Je crois que c'était une très bonne décision.
La porte à gauche, s'il vous plaît. Merci. Allô. Je dois commencer à parler.
Nous sommes This whole wing is called the West Wing.
It's called L'Aile Ouest.
Bien entendu, je ne connais pas la maison marche, mais je ne faisais pas le raccord.
I didn't see how it was connected to the main body, to the main center wing.
Well, I think we'd better get into our covers. I'm saying, how was the Oval Office?
Why is it over?
The room is
bigger.
The room is bigger. Parce que là, nous étions ce soir. Nous étions ce soir. Nous now a parlor.
Oui,
was
used by the
President, gentlemen, could we begin maybe with a discussion of East-West relations, and perhaps I could start by providing a brief summary of our meetings last week with the Soviet foreign minister. Our discussions with Shevardnadze last week were cordial and useful and covered our full agenda. Overall, the talks produced no breakthroughs. He had little new to add on the START Treaty, you know, is the name for the strategic missile treaty where we're trying to work out a 50% reduction in those weapons. Or on the defense or space talks. But on nuclear testing, I think we're close to completing the verification protocol for the peaceful nuclear explosions treaty. And we hope to finish this and a similar protocol for the Threshold Test Ban Treaty this year. He asked that we take seriously Gorbachev's proposal to convert Krasnoyarsk to an international space station. And we don't think this is an acceptable solution to that problem. It is a violation of the ABM Treaty. And it would be too easy, say, even if he didn't, but in some successor, to use that again in the way that it violates the treaty, in spite of their proposing that it be something for tracking space. There was a spirit of exchange on regional issues, but no real surprises. On CSCE, the Soviets are anxious to conclude the Vienna review meeting, and they told us they would drop their demand to exclude fighter aircraft from the mandate for new conventional talks. But we need a balanced outcome in Vienna that shows progress on human rights, and we're prepared to stay in Vienna until we get one. Last year we told the Soviets what it would take before we could consider their proposal for a human rights conference in Moscow, and they've begun to meet a few, but not all of our conditions. We appreciate that Mr. Gorbachev is pushing an ambitious domestic reform program in his country. We don't know whether he'll succeed, nor do we know what this all means for Western security. In looking at Soviet internal changes, we mustn't lose sight of what really counts, whether there will be any real and lasting change in their defense programs and policies. In New York on Tuesday, I met with all the NATO foreign ministers and representatives from Japan and Australia and South Korea. I think we came into an agreement that the Western alliance was in good shape and that we must continue as we have for 40 years to work together. There are some difficult decisions that will have to be made. Conventional weapons, arms control, burden sharing, and weapons modernization. In particular, NATO will have to tackle the short-range nuclear force modernization. The Conference of the Signatories of the 1925 General Protocol and other interested parties to strengthen international norms against the use of chemical weapons. And I understand that all the NATO countries have endorsed this idea as well.
Mr. President,
would France, because it is the depository of that Geneva Protocol, consider the relationship of our task and build on the growth and prosperity we've enjoyed in